You mentioned using that as a building block. How do you do that as a team and a coach whenever so much of that production came from one spot? Really?
Well, it's a team game, and I like what we have with this club. Our lineup is a lineup that's we can put seven seniors out there, and so everybody does their part. We're not going to rely on one particular guy that's got to carry the load. When you have an experienced lineup like we do, we think that'll carry its own weight. You know, as the season progresses.
What's going to make this team unique this season compared to last season?
I think the biggest thing, like we've talked about, is the leadership in that dugout. The guys that have been here for, you know, 3-4 years, what we did last year will allow our pitchers to continue to develop and get better as we prepare for conference and fight for a conference championship and fight to get in the conference tournament again.
How much do you feel like injuries last year just sort of kept you guys back from reaching that potential that you wanted to get to?
Well, you know, losing Michael Hicks and Colby Taylor, both of those guys were going to be on the front end of our rotation. And so immediately when the season started, we had to make some adjustments to our rotation. I thought the players that filled those roles stepped up and they did a really good job for us. Now, you know, having Michael back and Colby is getting really close to being ready to go. It's nice to have some guys that are healthy, guys that are experienced. Now that we just have to go out and we've got to execute.
What does Michael bring, just being a guy that's been here for a while, and although he was out last year, now that he's back, just what is it that you're looking for from him and just what he brings now that he's healthy?
I think the biggest thing is experience. You know, he's been there. He's an older guy now. He's been in the program for 3 years. And even though you sit out for a year, You can learn. You can learn. You can watch. You can observe. Watch how the game is played. Things that you can improve upon. Now, being a year older, I think that experience is really going to help them. You know, this year for us.
Have you set any specific goals for this year?
Well, the goals are going to remain the same. You know, the goals are going to remain the same, and they are. You know, we obviously want to chase the championship. And we want to go to Biloxi and go to the NCAA regionals, and we talk about that, but. Yeah, every player has individual goals, but our team goals are going to be the same. And you know, we feel like this group is a group that's going to push each other. I like the leadership of this group, and I like, you know, like I said, the lineup is an experienced lineup, so it should provide some exciting, you know, innings for us.
You all are returning 8 pitchers. You've lost 14 from last season. Are there any young guys that you're expecting to really step up and make a difference this year?
I think the biggest thing, not only on a pitching staff, is guys that, you know, some of the junior college players that we've brought in that I think are going to be an impact for us. You know, guys like Riley Boyd and Jake Cates can play the outfield. He can pitch. And then I think offensively, you know, we've got some guys, Junior Coleman in center field can really run the ball down. A freshman out of Paducah, Eric Reif, who can handle the bat, and he's very athletic. And so we've got some younger players. The thing for the position players is those older guys are going to lead the way, so those younger guys can step up at some point. And I feel like those guys are going to contribute in a big way.
How big of an emphasis was that, just getting experienced pitchers from that JUCO range, considering pitching kind of hurt a lot last year?
Yeah, well, I think that, like we mentioned, I think having, you know, Michael, Darryl Hicks back and Colby Taylor back, those two guys, and then you look at the job that Bailey Sutton did on the back end of games last year. When we moved him to the closing role, he was outstanding. He did a tremendous job. So we feel like, you know, from a pitching staff, we have more options that are going to be available to us. And the biggest key now is for these guys to stay healthy and continue to progress forward, you know, as the season moves along.
Are there any guys that you're planning to move now that maybe haven't played a certain role in that rotation, or is it just one of those sort of feel things out throughout the year?
I think, you know, going into the fall, going into the preseason, we're going to try to see what guys, you know, go where. I think, you know, your opening day lineup is going to be different in maybe 2-3 weeks from now. From a pitching standpoint, from a position standpoint, maybe not from a position standpoint as much because we've got older guys, but I think the team, the roles, they will evolve as we progress throughout the season.
Anything else for Coach?
One more question.
Yeah.
Losing a guy like Jake Sanford is obviously kind of tough for any team, that a guy that contributes that much. So what's kind of the message that you give to all your guys in losing a guy like that?
Well, everyone's got to do their part. You know, going into last season when, you know, we thought that Jake was going to do a great job for us. Nobody knew that he was going to be the conference player of the year, Triple Crown winner. And, you know, losing him obviously is a, you know, something where the rest of the team has to step up. And we're not going to ask one player to carry that load because that's tough to do. I mean, you're not going to see that type of numbers, what he put up often. And so the nine guys in that lineup, they're all going to have to chip in and contribute. So it's going to be a team effort. Versus one particular guy, but we've got some guys that I think are really going to do a great job for us and step up offensively.
Thanks, Coach.
Awesome.
Good.
Thank you. All righty.
All right.